Now we know the two runs, so let's finish everything else. Hey guys, Rado here with Dirt and Iron. So we are almost there. The bike is running pretty good. I didn't ride it yet, but you know, it runs, it starts, it idles, everything is good. And what we're gonna do in this video, we're gonna finish everything up. So I have some plastics here. This is my fender. I do have the number plates for the rear. And also we need to do our tank. But also we need to do our chain. And I have a bunch of nice bolts from spec bolts. We're gonna install as much as we can here in the garage in my place. And then as we normally do on the channel, when we finish our build, we go over to Dirt Bike TV garage, to Jade's garage, and we finish everything there. So we're gonna do some work here, then we're gonna pack, go over to Jade's garage, and I'm gonna see you there pretty soon. And one thing I wanna promise to you, that at the end of this video, you're gonna see a bike that I think you will like. One thing to remember, don't even think about skipping to the end of the video. I'm about to fade away, cause every time I wake up I feel like it's Monday. Something's going wrong with all the chemicals up in my brain. All of a sudden I don't look at anything the same way. Gotta build up of my thoughts sitting in an ashtray. I'm sorry that I'm so inconvenient, okay. Just let me be me and I'll stay out of your way. I can see the way you look at me, I'm such a disgrace. I never really asked to be brought into this place. You wanna love me? Well then baby I have a taste. All the highs and the lows, no you'll never be the same. I don't really wanna hurt you, but I can't control the pain. If you're sticking by my side, maybe we could be okay. Okay, okay, maybe you could be the change I need today. I promise that I've never felt this way. I really hope that you will choose to stay through all the pain.
I know you told your friend you're not okay, and tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. Guess you're trying to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray as you fade away.
Too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray
Alright, my friends, here we go. Dirty Iron build number 4 is done. 2007 Yamaha YZ250 off-road build, or a woods build, whatever you choose to call it, is done. It's finished and I want to hear your opinion. So after this video is over, please go below and comment, let me know what you think about this build, how you like it, the feedback I'm getting from you guys. That's it's really a great thing, you know, to read. So after all is done and said, I really like to go back and read all the comments and then respond to all of you guys. So don't forget to comment. First, I want to say a big thank you and give a shout out to Brett and Mark, who are watching the channel, and they have the company called Moto Blasters. They are doing Cerakoting and hydroblasting. They reached out to me in the beginning of this build. They wanted to help me with all the hydroblasting and Cerakoting. So everything beautifully Cerakoted on this bike and everything hydroblasted on this bike is from Moto Blasters, from Mark and Brett, which is son and father, you know, duo. They ride bikes together, they watch my channel, and they wanted to help. So big thank you. And second thing I want to say is to Scott Meredith, who reached out to me also. He's the guy watching a channel, one of us, and he reached out to me and he said that I have a bunch of parts from 250X that I don't need, such as transmission, CDI and some other things, head, and I can just ship it to you. You can use it for your build. So thank you so much, guys, for watching, and thank you for willing to help, you know, and reach out to me and help me. I really appreciate that. Other than that, all the companies involved in this build, and Jay Clark, who helped me, and also Brett from Parapros. Thank you, guys. As you can see, we have this blue, white, black and gray combination. You know, I didn't want to do something too crazy. I still wanted to keep this Yamaha heritage. This is a YZ, so I wanted to keep it look like YZ, but at the same time do something a little bit unique. So we decided to start from the front of the bike with a blue and white, and then as you go towards the rear, we're gonna transition into black and gray. And also the seat is white on the top to kind of tie everything together. So this is the color combination we went for, and Moto Seat and Decal MX, these two companies, they help us to design this, help us to come with the design and with the colors that are matching. So big shout out to them as well. Also the Decal MX, you know, they did this special decals for a tank. Since I'm running IMS tank, the big tank, they're coming all the way to the top, and I think it looks way better than if it would be just all the way till here. So for the look of the bike, I'm stoked, guys. I think it looks really amazing. These little details, you know, little parts, white, blue, black, gray, I think everything looks great. So let me know below in the comments again how you like the look of the bike. Now, as for the build, you know what we did, as we usually do, we went all the way to the frame and start replacing everything. So factory links send us all the bearings that we need for the linkage swing arm, for the rear shock, and also for the steering stem. So all the bearings are new, replaced, re-greased, so the bike should feel like brand new now. Then once that was done, we send our suspension to Racetech, and they set it to my skill, my level, my weight, and kind of riding I'm gonna do. And I have really good experience with this guy, so I'm expecting that this bike will handle really good on the trails. After the suspension, we got the engine, that we put a lot of work into the engine. When we took it apart, we found a few things are broken or missing. We need to replace the cylinder, we need to buy some parts for our power valve. So we sent cylinder over to Tom Morgan Racing. He did the porting for us, he cut the head for us, and also he replaced it, the Millennium replaced the cylinder. So after we had that back, we went over to Parapros, and Brad over at Parapros helped us to build this engine, put everything together. So we got a full Range Rabbit kit with vertex piston, hard rod bottom, all the bearings, seals actually are from Cometic. So all these we got, and we also got a full Hinson clutch. And as you can see, we also did a lot of Cerakoting pieces on this engine, and these little bolts that look so beautiful are from spec bolts. And actually every single bolt on this bike is from the spec bolts. We got this restoration kit. All right, after that was done, we threw everything into the frame and start building it one by one. We got a brand new set of wheels from Tusk. This is Tusk Impact, the blue anodized hubs and black rims. I think these wheels look really good, and they are also proven really sturdy wheels. Also we got a front and rear rotors from Tusk. Front is oversized, and also we got the braided lines, some other small pieces from Tusk like shifter, brake pedal. Of course we're running Dunlop tires, 8081 in the front and in the rear, since this is an off-road bike, and in the rear, just to mention that we have an 18-inch rear wheel. For the carburetor, we decided to go this time with the Smart Carb SC2. This supposed to help with the elevation and temperature changes. It will adjust to the elevation and to temperature, and also give us better fuel economy. And also, we're supposed to give us a little better power. So definitely, we'll check back with you guys after we have several hours on the bike how this Smart Carb SC2 runs. We have a full FMF system, gnarly pipe and turbine core too, because we need to be spark arrested here in California, so we are running that. As I mentioned, we have IMS big tank for this longer trail rides. Hopefully I'll be able to do some longer trail rides this time. Fly Racing handlebars. This is a KTM band. This is the band that I feel comfortable with. Over here on the handlebars, we have a bunch of pieces from Works Connection. We have this clutch perch set up from Works Connection, and a little anodized things. And as if you notice here, we have everything blue. So everything anodized here is blue. And then going towards the rear of the bike, we have some black pieces from Works Connection. So we wanted to keep this transition blue into black also with our, anodized pieces. And Enduro Engineering handguards, wraparounds, very light and durable handguards over here. Then once that was done, we got a full plastic kit from, this is a Restyle, UFO Restyle plastic kit. As you can see, we are not running these new airbags. We are keeping the old airbags, but running the Restyle kit from UFO. And I think it looks really good. It looks a little bit different than your new bike, but I think it still looks pretty good. So we decided to keep old airbags and run the Restyle kit. Super Sprag wrist bracket, front sprocket, and heavy duty O-ring chain that will work really great for a trail riding. Now, TM Design Work, they have this very durable chain slide and then chain guide, and I decided to use the same company also for the other side of the rear wheel and go with the TM Design Work for the shark fin and the brake caliper protection. So everything in the rear is the same color, same company, so everything look nicely uniform in the rear of the bike. We are running carbon fiber ignition cover from Lightspeed that looks really good. It looks so much better than stock plastic cover. To help cool the bike on the trails, we are running Boysen super cooler water pump that is pushing more water through the radiator, so it will help us to run a little bit cooler. As we usually do for two-stroke builds and for two-stroke bikes we ride on the channel, we are using P3 carbon protection for the pipe. For this build, I decided to go with the AXP Extreme skid plate. It's covering everything from the front all the way to the linkage, and this is a very thick 8mm plastic, very durable, so we decided to go with AXP this time. Bulletproof design radiator guards, and these guards are blue anodized because they're in front of the bike, right? We are running SCAR titanium foot pegs that are nice and wide and also pretty sharp, so you're gonna feel planted on this bike. Kickstand from Fastway Pro Motobile that's matching all the aluminum parts. It looks really good and it's also very sturdy. I'm not riding it in this video because we are going to give this bike to Dirtbag Magazine in a couple days, and they are going to do a shooting, riding, testing, and this bike also will be featured in a Dirtbag Magazine, which I'm really stoked that we can work together with Dirtbag Magazine and have this bike feature in the printed version as well. This is first time that my bike will be featured like that, and it's really something, so I'm really grateful for that. All right, my friends, I think that's about it for today. I'm probably forgetting some small pieces. I'll put the entire list below in the description, so you can go through everything. You can see every single little piece we use for this bike. And as for now, as I said, this bike is ready to go to Dirt Bike Magazine, and I'm gonna have it back maybe in a week. And after that, you bet we're gonna take it for some good ride, and we're gonna share a lot of footage with you guys, the impression. Maybe we can compare this bike to a newer 250X. Let's see what we can do. For now, I'm really stoked and happy that we are finally done with 250 YZ250 built. And as I said, guys, let me know below in the comments how you like it, what you think about this bike, how it turned out, colors, components, design, everything on this bike. I want to hear your opinion. All right, my friends, well, thanks for watching, and don't forget, whatever you do, stay motivated. See you guys later.